Today we are going to discuss about the attachment of the humerus. Humerus have two surfaces. This one is the anterior view or the anterior surface, and this one is the posterior view or the posterior surface. As the humerus is a long bone and it is divided into three parts, this one is the upper part. From here, this one is the upper part. This one is the shaft of the humerus, and this one is the lower part or the lower end of the humerus. And the upper part is divided into the head, anatomical neck, lesser tubercle, greater tubercle. Here is a surgical neck. And as we know, this one is the head of the humerus joined or articulate with the glenoid cavity of the scapula. So you can say that it's formed the shoulder joint or the glenohumeral joint. And the capsular ligament of shoulder joint or the capsular ligament of the glenohumeral joint articulate or the aligned with the anatomical neck. But on the medial side, it extend downward, and it also include the shaft. From here it come like this, but on the medial side, this one is the medial side, and on the medial side it include the shaft of the humerus. And this one is a lesser tubercle and this one is a greater tubercle. The lesser tubercle give insertion of a one muscle which is named as a subscapularis muscle. This one is a greater tubercle. Greater tubercle give the insertion of the three muscles, or the give the impression of the three muscles, as it is divided into the upper impression. This one is the upper impression, and upper impression give the insertion of the supraspinatus muscle. This one is a middle part, and the middle part give the insertion of the infraspinatus muscles. And this one is a lower part, and the lower part give the insertion of the teres minor muscles. This one give the insertion of the teres minor muscle. And this part is known as a bicipital groove, the part which is divided the lesser tubercle and greater tubercle. This part is known as a bicipital groove or the intertubercular sulcus. In the intertubercular sulcus, the tendon of the long head of the bicep brachii pass downward from the bicipital groove. The anterior circumflex humeral artery pass upward, and the tendon of the long head of the bicep brachii pass downward. And as we know, this form of floor and the floor of the bicipital groove or the intertubercular sulcus give the insertion of the latissimus dorsi muscles, and it form to the two lip. This is the medial lip, and this form the lateral lip. The medial lip give the insertion of the teres major muscle, give the insertion of the teres major muscle, and the lateral lip give the insertion of the pectoralis major muscle. And this is known as a lateral epicondyle, while this is known as a medial epicondyle. While this is known as a medial epicondyle because this part is toward the head. This one is toward the head, so this is known as a medial epicondyle, and this is known as a lateral epicondyle. The medial epicondyle is larger than the lateral epicondyle. It gives the origin of the common extensor muscles. And above the lateral epicondyle, there is a ridge-like structure which is known as a supracondylar ridge, On the lateral side, this is known as a lateral supracondylar ridge, and on the medial side, this is known as a medial supracondylar ridge. So if we come to the lateral side, on the lateral epicondyle, it gives the origin of the common extensor muscles anteriorly. Anteriorly, it gives the origin of the common extensor muscles. So it is also known as a common extensor muscles. And on the posteriorly, on the back side, it gives the origin onconeus muscles on the posterior surface. And The lateral supracondylar ridges part is known as the lateral supracondylar ridge because it is above the lateral epicondyle. This upper two-third give the attachment of the brachioradialis muscles. The remaining one-third give the attachment of the extensor carpi radialis longus muscle. This one. And we have discussed about the lateral side. Now we will come to the medial side. On the medial side, it contains the medial epicondyle and the medial supracondylar ridge. On the medial epicondyle, it gives the region of the common flexor muscles. It is the site of the region of the common flexor muscles. So on the medial epicondyle, it gives the region of the common flexor muscles and medial supracondylar ridge. This one is the medial supracondylar ridge. It gives the attachment of the pronator teres muscle. This gives the region of the pronator teres muscles. And it also lined or joined the capsular ligament of the elbow joint, which cross the, this one is the coronoid fossa, then radial fossa, and as it come to posteriorly, like as that posteriorly, and it cross the olecranon fossa, and again it come to the medial side, and it hold the cover from the coronoid fossa, radial fossa, literally here, and then come to the posteriorly side, and from the posteriorly it also cover the olecranon fossa, and this all is covered by the capsular ligament of the elbow joint. This part is known as a deltoid tuberosity. This is known as a deltoid tuberosity, and this gives the attachment of the deltoid muscle. This gives the attachment of the deltoid muscles. And behind the deltoid tuberosity, on the posterior surface, there is present of the spiral groove or the radial groove. In the posterior, if you come here, this one is a spiral groove or the radial groove, and from the spiral or the radial groove, there runs or come the radial nerve, past the radial nerve, and if there is a fracture of this side, and then it causes the problem or the damage of the radial nerve, and also there is pass of the profundi brachii artery, and it also damage the profundi brachii artery. Hope so you understand. And also there is present of the crocobrachialis muscles. As we know, the humerus have the three borders. This one is a medial border, the border which is toward the head. It is known as a medial border, and this one is known as an anterior border. This one is an anterior border, and this one is known as a lateral border. And from the medial border to the anterior border, this is known as a anteromedial surface, and from the anterior border to the lateral border, this is known as an lateral surface. And above the radial groove, this one is a radial, and above the radial groove to the this one is a medial border. Above the radial groove to the medial border, this give the attachment of the muscle which is known as a crocobrachialis muscles. This give the attachment of the crocobrachialis muscles. And also this present of the brachialis muscles on the lower half of the radial groove, on the lower half of the radial groove, on the anteromedially and anterolaterally surface, it gives the attachment of the brachialis muscles. Mean that this one is the anteromedially and this one is the anterolaterally, the whole one contain or the attachment of the brachialis muscle. And the last one muscle, which is known as the tricep muscles, tricep muscle have three head. The first one is a long head. The long head give the attachment of the region to the infraglenoid cavity of the scapula. We have discussed the infraglenoid cavity, and the infraglenoid cavity or the infraglenoid tubercle of the scapula give the attachment of the long head, and the lateral head give the attachment above, from the above of the radial groove on the posterior side,
it give the attachment of the lateral head above the radial groove, and below the radial groove it give the attachment of the medial head. Some nerves which comes in contact with the humerus bone, surgical neck, and there's a axillary nerve which come in contact with the surgical neck, and if there is a fracture of the surgical neck, then the axillary nerve can be damaged. And it most fractured part of the humerus, it mostly fractured into the old age person which have the osteoporosis, mean that low level of the minerals it can. And this one is a deltoid tuberosity. Behind the deltoid tuberosity, we know there is present of the spiral groove from which the spiral nerve or the radial nerve pass. And if there is a fracture of this from the shaft, if there is a fracture of the shaft, then it can cause of the radial nerve of the damage. And fracture from the shaft cause the low in size of the limb, and this part is known as a, we know that this is known as a medial part, and this one is a lateral part. This one is a medial epicondyle, and medial epicondyle, from the medial epicondyle there's pass of the one nerve which is known as the ulnar nerve. So if there is a damage of this region, if there is a damage of this region or the medial epicondyle, then it so if there is a fracture of the this region, then it causes the damage of the which nerve, then it causes the damage of the ulnar nerve. And if this one is a condylar regions, this one is a condylar regions, and if there is a fracture of this region, then it give the damage of the medial
sketch or draw the all muscles or the all attachment of the humerus. Then this one is a surgical neck, and it give the capsular ligament, and this one is a laser tubercle. The laser tubercle subscapularis muscles insertion. This give the three impression. The first one is the supraspinatus. This one is the infraspinatus, and this one give the insertion of the teres minor muscle. This one is the floor of the bicipital groove. The floor of the bicipital groove give the insertion of the latissimus dorsi, and the medial lip give the insertion of the teres major muscle. The lateral lip give the insertion of the pectoralis major muscles. And there is a deltoid tuberosity give the attachment of the deltoid muscle. Behind the deltoid muscle there is a spiral groove, radial nerve can pass, and the upper two-thirds of the supracondylar ridge give the attachment of a muscle which is known as a brachioradialis muscle. This one give the brachioradialis, and the lower one-third give the attachment of the carpus radialis longus, extensor carpus radialis longus muscles. It give the supracondylar give the pronator teres muscles, PT, pronator teres. All medial epicondyle, this give the origin of the flexor muscles, and these all give the attachment are the on the extensor muscles. And brachioradialis muscles, crocobrachialis muscles, and this one is a medial part, and above this give the crocobrachialis. Above the glera, this one is tuberosity, and below this give the brachioradialis.
anteromedial and the anterolateral brachioradialis, BR, brachioradialis muscles. So this was all about that.